Let's move to the NFL. And we've got a lot to discuss with that, of course. Eli Manning has retired. He announced the retirement. I believe, he didn't. The Giants did, and he's going to make his big thing on Friday. So if you're listening to this on Friday morning, there you go. Eli Manning retired. Is he a first ballot Hall of Famer? A lot of people were discussing the fact that, you know, he gets out of the NFL a year before any of these other guys, Drew Brees, Roethlisberger, Brady, et cetera. Like, all these guys are expected to play again next year. Who else is going to be in the same class as him, the same year?
Well, you're going to have other people that didn't get in on their first ballot that's going to be in those classes. Right. I don't know that first ballot matters. Is he a Hall of Famer? I think so. I think he gets in the Hall of Fame. And I think he gets in, you know, in his lifetime. We're not going to have this situation where 40 years from now he dies and he never got in.
No, okay? I agree. I agree. I think he's a first ballot guy. I think he gets in immediately. Two Super Bowl MVPs, top 10 in passing, top 10 in touchdowns. He's a Manning, for God's sake.
He gets in first ballot, it will strictly be his name and name alone.
I think
that's,
you're right.
And that's true. And I'm not knocking the guy. I think he had an unbelievable career. He made a ridiculous amount of money. He came into the league at the perfect time
He leads the NFL in money earned.
Damn straight.
That's insane to me.
Checks cash by the NFL. Guy's got him. And he's here's what I always thought about Eli, okay? Eli's got a lot of criticisms, all right? He's got a lot of flaws. He's got a lot of holes in his game that you can knock him and you can make fun of him about. One thing you can't argue is he did more with less than almost anybody in the league. I truly believe that outside of Tom Brady, he did more with less in his career because he didn't have a ton of stars. There aren't a whole lot of other Hall of Famers that he played alongside most of his career.
He had OBJ, but he didn't do much with OBJ. But aside from that, the big names that made big plays for him in the Super Bowl, it was David Tyree, it was Sterling Shepard. These are not Jeremy Shockey, I guess. Yeah. Who else did he have?
Plexico Burress had a big catch, but Plexico came there at the end of his career. Yeah.
After he had already made a name for
himself. Offensive line was kind of always shaky and not great. The defense was every now and then great and every now and then kind of atrocious. And you kind of never knew, were they going to be really good or really bad from season to season? I just thought he accomplished so much more than I think realistically the expectations were set.
Had he done this anywhere besides New York, I think we wouldn't even be having the conversation. This would have been a Hall of Fame career at any other stop. You think they would want two Super Bowls at Cincinnati, at Cleveland?
Just think about it.
Say he had done this with the Chargers. I think just the postseason success alone.
I'm a defender of Philip Rivers in this situation all the time. I think both of them are great. Philip has always had substantially more talent around him than Eli ever did.
Yes.
100%. Now, Philip didn't have to go through Peyton and Tom to get to a Super Bowl, which is why he never made it to one. He couldn't beat those two guys, those two teams. And Eli didn't have to do that. There was no elite juggernaut in the NFC that he had to go through. True. Both times he won it, they won it from the wild card playing on the road, and they were 8-8 throughout the season. Didn't matter. They got in, got hot, won it all.
Yeah. And that's partly what led me to think that the Titans had a chance to make it to the Super Bowl this year.
That's right. Yeah, because we've seen it happen.
Yeah.
We've seen it happen in recent memory with these guys.
The next topic I wanted to bring up, Antonio Brown has an arrest warrant out. I don't think that they have actually arrested him yet, but I would assume that the Hollywood, Florida Police Department will make an appearance at his home on Friday. What path is he going down? How much credit do the Steelers deserve for putting up with him as long as they did? And do you think that this is what happens to guys after not playing football? Do you think
the Steelers don't deserve any credit, Gary, because they didn't put up with any of this stuff. He didn't do any of this crap when he was there.
Well, I'm wondering if there was
any of this. And if he did, then they covered it up and they didn't get the guy help.
That's a good point. That's a very good point.
Because if he did some of this junk, and some of this crap happened under their watch, you know, him sexually assaulting that girl happened while he was in Pittsburgh playing for them.
That's true.
They got a history of covering up for sexual assault, dudes. So, I mean, you know, it's just one of those things where I don't know that they're not to blame for some of this, but I am very big on personal accountability. This is not the Steelers' fault. Now, they're not. Listen, you're trying to make them out to be heroes in this deal.
Well, not heroes, but
they're villains, if anything else. Well, they're accomplices.
If you look at who they had on the roster with those two guys, with Le'Veon Bell and Antonio Brown, with the egos and all of the mess that comes along with them.
And Ben Roethlisberger with the ego and the mess.
And they were able to kind of keep this, like, in-house. Quiet.
Keep the hush-hush, very much college town.
Keep it hush-hush.
Where we can make stuff disappear.
But also be able to win. Like, they were able to win.
Well, if Antonio Brown was on the field this year and all this stuff didn't come to light and somebody was able to keep it hush-hush and to sweep it under rugs, then I think that team would have won. If he was playing for the Bills, if he was playing for the Raiders, they're making the playoffs.
Do you think
and they're making a playoff run.
Do you think any of this happens – like that's going on with him right now, do you think any of this happens if he was playing?
Yeah, because I think the guy's gone insane. I think he's gone over a cliff at some point in time. Something in his brain has snapped. I mean, Drew Rosenhaus, his agent, has dissolved himself from all of this. He's washed his hands and says, I'm out. And that guy can put up with a lot.
Yeah.
And that guy has dealt with some tough customers over the years. And he has eaten his plate of shit in the past, and he ain't eating this.
No, he decided.
And that tells me Drew knows the truth, and Drew knows this guy is guilty as sin of everything he's been accused of, and it's only a matter of time before it all falls down, and he will not be attached to it.
I feel bad because
it's sad.
It's sad. Like he's got kids.
But this is the bed he's made, man. I mean, just because somebody's got kids, dude, if you're an asshole, you're an asshole. If you're a terrible person, you're a terrible person.
Yeah, no, you're right.
Sometimes bad things happen to good people, and they didn't really do anything wrong, but somebody wants to make an example out of them. This is not that. No, this isn't that at all.
I agree with you. Let's talk about something positive to end the NFL talk. The Pro Bowl is this weekend down in Orlando, and Lamar Jackson is the star of the show. I did not realize how popular he is with kids, man. So we went to eat dinner at the commissary tonight, and there was just a table full of kids with their parents and all this, and it was friends that obviously had just come from playing a basketball game or something like that, and they were talking about all this NBA stuff, and the only NFL player that they discussed at all was Lamar Jackson. That's not the first that I've heard of it. Like, Lamar Jackson is a friggin' superstar. And you see all the videos of him with the kids down there. Drew Brees' kids, you know, wanted Lamar Jackson autographs. They had all the Baltimore Ravens gear on and everything. I don't know if you saw that, but that blew me away. I was very surprised by it. I don't know why.
I don't know why either. You were late to the party on this, man. I told you this guy is going to be a superstar. He's going to destroy this league.
He is so insanely likable. Like, it's crazy.
Yep.
He's awesome. So
he's everything positive you could want in your quarterback and your leader of your team.
Yeah.
And in the face of your franchise, he is everything you could absolutely desire. They ran into a buzzsaw. I think taking 2 weeks off really hurt that team. And I also think that a lot of credit has to go to the Titans and Vrabel and just being able to be prepared and just said, we're going to shut Lamar down and you got to find another way to beat us. And I'm going to put three guys behind him. Not one, not two. I'm going to put three. I'm going to put one on the left, one on the right, one in the center, and he's not going anywhere.
Yeah.
And we're going man-to-man defense everybody else, and we're not going to blitz him.
You brought up desire. Lamar is everything you would desire out of a quarterback. What about this Pro Bowl? Is there anything that you actually want to see? Are you going to watch it? How's that?
No, I won't watch a second.
I don't think I will either.
I won't watch 1 second of it.
The only
thing I ever enjoy about the Pro Bowl week is the skills competition stuff.
Yeah.
But But that used to be like a big thing, one day, whatever. Now they've got some weird schedule where they spread it out and they videotape it in different segments. I'm not following all week the Pro Bowl crap. I don't care.
Yeah, I agree.
Well, give me, if you want to give me one day, you want to film it all week and do all that, but then air it one day cut up and give me like a 3-hour show, I'm in, and you'll get my viewership because I really like the skill stuff. I like watching these guys do goofy things, but they're
but
not,
you're not
doing
to search for it for days.
No. Like, and I'm not going to spend all week looking at a little bit here and a little bit there. I'm going to get in. I'm going to get out.
Not with the Senior Bowl going on, because right now a bunch of the stuff that's out is, you know, Senior Bowl practices and everybody getting ready for Saturday's game. We want to see what's going on with Jalen Hurts and with Justin Herbert and all that. Like, where are these guys going to go? What are they going to end up doing? I think football fans are more interested in what's coming next as opposed to a game that the players don't even care enough about for the majority of them to even show up, you know?
Yeah.
And so let's go on and move on from that.